We have a CBS News investigation into the use of electric shock to change harmful behaviors in children and adults with development disabilities, including autism. The method has been used for more than 20 years, and each case is approved by a state judge. But recently, the United Nations likened the method to torture, and now the FDA is considering a ban. The shock method is used in only one school, the private Judge Rodenberg Center near Boston. Anna Werner went inside to hear from those who support the method and from others, including former student Jennifer Masumba, who told the FDA that the school has gone too far.
How many times a day do you think you were shocked?
In the beginning, I was shocked every day.
Jennifer Masumba has autism. For 7 years, she lived here at the Judge Rodenberg Center in Massachusetts, where she wore a backpack like this one, sometimes 24 hours a day. Inside is a device attached to electrodes that deliver a shock whenever a staffer presses a button on a remote carried on their belt. The center claims it stops bad or aggressive behavior.
I felt like I was being punished for being born. That's what it feels like. Because I was disabled, I was being punished.
Part of Masumba's treatment plan was for staffers to draw up a list of prohibited behaviors, ranging from headbanging to hand movements, for which she could be shocked.
I would get like 5 or 10 shocks for just doing one thing.
What was that like?
That was like being underground in hell.
The center's use of electric shock came under scrutiny in 2012 after this videotape was presented in a court case. No! It showed 17-year-old Andre McCollins, seen here in the upper right-hand corner, tied to a restraint board by his arms and legs, then shocked 31 times. Andre's now 29. His mother, Cheryl McCollins, settled a lawsuit against the center, but says her son has suffered permanent damage and she wants shock treatment outlawed.
It doesn't work. Shock him out of autism? What is that gonna do? Inflicting pain, it's like you're making the injury worse.
The center says it no longer uses the restraint board in combination with shocks, but they insist a program of electric shocks, shocks they compare to a bee sting, works better than medication to stop people with severe disabilities from injuring themselves or others. They point to residents such as 20-year-old Joshua Wood, who has severe autism. His parents are Sharon and Roger Wood.
He would just go into severe rages that he could not control. He would grab his head and cry. And so my daughter, ourselves, we would hide, lock ourselves in the bedroom and just hope that Josh wouldn't hurt himself.
So when they talk about parents being desperate, I mean, you evidently know exactly what that feels like.
You have to understand the entire journey. From day one, as a parent, you do everything imaginable, unimaginable, whatever. I mean, sometimes you grasp at straws.
Has he told you what it's like?
He's nonverbal.
Give him a hug. Give me a hug.
High five, everybody. All right.
Joshua's parents say he's now able to participate in activities like this lunch set up by the school.
I was just so thrilled to see the difference in him and to be able to see him smile. That I was just like, this is a godsend.
As he ate, a staffer with a remote control for the shock device stood nearby.
Have you seen him get shocked?
No.
Neither of you?
No, we've seen him like right after, and he's been totally fine, like when we've come to visit the school or come to pick him up.
Jennifer Masumba says parents don't see everything that happens at the center. She says shocks were often given at random. And she says her own mother did not know she went through experiences similar to that seen on the video of Andre McCollins before she left in 2009.
That hurts. Can you describe it for me?
It's so scary. I would ask God to make my heart stop because I didn't want to live when that was happening to me. I just wanted to die and make it stop.
Do you think that the students fear the shock?
No. No, I don't.
Glenda Crooks is the center's director.
When you put that device on them, it's they're not hurting themselves anymore. They're not hurting other people anymore. And their affect, it just changes. Like, no, I don't afraid to think they're afraid of it.
But it is painful to them.
It is painful.
And you think they don't fear that?
I don't. You need to experience the day-to-day goings-on, and it happens so few and far between. It's very rare that someone gets an application. They know what they get the application for, so it's not a fearful thing.
It's easy to control people when you hurt them. That's easy. That's all they've ever done.
Misumba now lives at a group home in Florida, where her therapy includes playing the piano and positive feedback reinforcement.
Anna, what's become of Jennifer Misumba's case?
Well, Scott, Jennifer Misumba is now suing the Judge Rotenberg Center. We asked center officials about her case. They told us that she did well there and, in fact, sent positive emails to the center after leaving in 2009. But Jennifer Misumba says it took her 2 years to process her experience there and recover from what she calls abuse.
Fascinating story. Thank you, Anna. We have more on all of this.